The Vector drive is designed with internal load monitoring so that it's able to protect itself from damage in an overload condition. In spite of this, it's possible for a Vector drive to fail in a non-resettable way. Here are some quick tests you can do to determine if the Vector drive is actually damaged. Before you start, set the main circuit breaker to the off position and wait until the red LED on the Vector drive goes out. If the LED is still on, there may be a lethal level of voltage on the DC bus. Before you perform any operation on the Vector drive, make sure the LED has gone out completely. Then, to double check, use a voltmeter to make sure there is no voltage at the positive and negative terminals. Once you're certain that there is no voltage in the Vector drive, label and remove the leads from the DC bus. In our tests, we want to make sure we are only measuring resistance through the Vector drive itself. First, check the output on the positive side of the DC bus. Set your multimeter to resistance test mode and put the black lead onto terminal 2. It's labeled with a plus sign. Use the red lead to measure the resistance to motor terminals 9, 10, and 11. These are labeled A, B, and C. The meter should show high resistance readings, typically in the range of kilo or mega ohms. If your meter reads very low resistance, the Vector drive is damaged. Check the output on the negative side of the DC bus. With the multimeter still set to resistance test mode, put the black lead onto terminal 3. It's labeled with a minus sign. Touch the red lead to terminals 9, 10, and 11 again. As in the positive side test, the meter should show high resistance readings, typically in the range of kilo or mega ohms. If your meter reads very low resistance, the Vector drive is damaged. Now let's check the regen load. Make sure the multimeter is still set to resistance mode. Touch your red lead to terminal 1 and the black lead to terminal 3. As before, if the circuit is good, you'll see a high resistance. Low resistance means the circuit is blown and the Vector drive needs to be replaced. Finally, check the status of the bridge rectifier. Still in resistance mode, touch the black lead to the machine chassis. Touch the red lead to terminals 4, 5, and 6. These are on the input side of the bus and are labeled A, B, and C. If it shows open, the bridge rectifier is good. A low resistance reading indicates the bridge rectifier has failed and that the Vector drive needs to be replaced. Now that you've determined the Vector drive has failed, it's important to eliminate other possible causes. Check the spindle motor cables, the regen assembly, and the delta Y assembly if fitted, for shorts or for other damage. Make sure that you identify and repair any problems here before you replace the Vector drive, or you just might damage the new one in the same way. That's it for today. Thank you for watching.